Okay, I'm almost done to setting to reset. I just need it all to get engulfed with flames, right? So in my next layer, or my next frames, I'm just going to increase the brightness. And the texture. And I might even create just a brand new asset layer that I fill. And I'm going to fill it with white, but then take its opacity down a little bit, right? Maybe set to, let's see, linear dodge. Yeah, it doesn't really matter. Yeah, just to normal. Okay, and then yeah, nothing else really matters anymore. I'm gonna pose the creature. I can still see the creature, it's silhouetted. Pose it one more time. Because he's got a glow around him now, he's just kind of a blob. But he's just firing his heart out. I'm going to try this. I'm going to take all the fire and just move it a little bit. Yeah, that worked. That represents probably like 60 layers or so of fire layered up. And then I'll move the clouds, but I doubt you'll even be able to tell. And I'll move the stars, but I doubt you'll be able to tell. And then almost done. So option, merge visible. Select all. Command C, copy. Command V, paste it in. Then go back and just keep brightening it up. So now I can take this opacity up a little bit. At this point, I may as well just do the fading into the cloud. Vary this a little bit. And maybe even just take down the opacity of my creature a little bit. And pose it maybe one more time. So you see kind of the struggling shadow in the smoke. Oh, and I do want to turn off some of these. There we go. So it's kind of obscuring all of it. Yep, and I'll just move the stars just in case we can see a little twinkle of them. Yeah, we can still see some dots there. All right, so that's a pretty good final frame. Option, layer, merge visible. The shortcut for select all is Command A. Copy, the shortcut for copy is Command C. And then paste, and the shortcut for paste is Command B. And then last one, I'm just gonna go just really basic, almost pure white. And then I'm just gonna pose the creature, just because I like this idea of it struggling, like barely perceptibly. Pose it one more time with Puppet Warp. you know, through all the smoke. Actually, quite nice smoke. And then the stars. Okay. Hold down option, merge visible. This will be my last keyframe. Select all, copy, paste. Now, I'm gonna save my stage. And now I'm gonna do my finished animation on the timeline. So I've made all my keyframes. So I make my frames from layers. And now any extra animation I do, I'm going to do on the stage, which means changes I make will be permanent to the animation. So that's what it looks like if I don't set the timing. And you can see how that kind of big overtake of the flame works. So let's set it all to be 0.3. I'm actually going to try 0.25. Now I can be a little bit more precise. You can go to two decimals. Yeah, works pretty well. So I'm actually going to do 0.3 because with all the processing that Photoshop does and the millions of colors, when it actually gets processed as a GIF with only 256 colors, it's going to move a little bit faster than what I'm seeing right now. All right. So now notice that it just goes from the bright white straight back to here. So how can I get it to transition? Now, these are some of the animating on the stage tools. You'll see them here. The most common is what's called the tween tool, the in-between. And what I can do is I can click any two panels. So I'm going to click the last frame, hold down Command, and select the first. So I have the last one selected and the first one. Then I'm going to click the tween, and I'm going to add, I'll add five frames. And it will add five frames that slowly crossfade the two. So it will fade back in. So let's see how that looks. Now remember, the checkerboard in Photoshop means there's nothing there, right? So if it was on a white background, that would fill in with white. But if I don't want to worry about that, because GIFs do support transparency, then what I want to do is on all those transitions, I want to select all five of those in-betweens, and then I want to turn on, a new layer behind them. It's a little complicated. Then I'm going to edit fill with white, 100%. So now I won't see that checkerboard anymore at the end. I'll play it from here just so you can see. And it will fade in nicely. Okay, so do I have a transformation of my creature? Somewhat, right? He changes color a little bit, his eyes bulge, but the big transformation is of the setting. And it does start with a zoom in, but what I think I like best is that the stars are moving consistently. Now it's hanging up on certain frames a little bit just because of the processing. So when I finalize it, everything should move smoothly. So how do we do that? We say file, save. Once we have our animation playing the way we want, we save it as a PSD file. So our stage file is our final Photoshop animation. And we're gonna need that to make our storyboard. Right now I have 32, that's actually not bad, 32 frames, right? Now I'm gonna say file export, because I want to save it as a GIF file, but not just save as a GIF, because then it would just be one image at really low quality. I want to save it as a web legacy GIF, which allows for an animation script. So if I say save for web legacy, it will bring up a new menu. We want to keep most of the defaults. We can shrink the preview down so we can see it. But the problem with a GIF is it's limited to no more than 256 colors. So we want all 256 colors. We want it to be selective. I set the quality to be bicubic smoother, but you can just play it through and see. Yeah, that looks pretty good. And then you hit save. Now I had one concern. I'm going to save it to the desktop. And I'm going to save this as version 1. Because I can then test it in a web browser. But I remember when I was first doing the animation test, I had a concern about this edge. So I want to see if that concern is still valid. So I'm watching this edge. And no, I don't see any problem with it now. So it might have been what's called pixel slippage that happens with GIFs sometimes. And it just moved one pixel. Oh, I do see it now. Ha ha. You have to be zoomed in enough to see it. Okay, you see that little flashing? That's just a one pixel dimension. It's really annoying. But to fix it, I'm just going to move my guide right inside of it. I have to zoom in to get there. It's just one pixel. And then I'm going to crop the whole thing to fit that guide. So I clear the ratio for the crop tool because it's not going to be a perfect square anymore. It's going to be very close, just one pixel shy. And then I won't have that issue anymore. And it's actually a good idea at this point to say delete cropped pixels and then just crop your whole thing. Because I have a lot of like floating fire pixels and stuff out on the edge. They're just taking up a lot of memory. So by doing that, I'll save some memory. And then it should play through a little bit better. Now remember, I have all those assets in the assets folder. So I don't lose anything by cropping them on the stage. And you're right, actually, I don't have any extras because I already moved it over. But anyway, it's a good idea to understand where everything comes from. Okay, so save it as a Photoshop file and then export, save for web legacy. This is going to be my finished GIF. And then this is the next thing I'm going to put up to PhotoBucket. And you test it by opening it in a web browser. Because to have an animated script with the GIF means that it will automatically play at the timing you set. So it's very important you set your timing for your frames, and it's very important you click forever. Otherwise, it will just play through once, or it will just play through three times. And you want it to keep playing through. So how do you test it? I'm going to say open with, or I can just drag it down to my Chrome tab here, and you'll see it. And a nice resolution, even though it's only 256 colors, you can see a lot of detail. See the stars keep rotating. The clouds keep moving. The texture on the water keeps changing. And at full resolution, yeah, it fills the screen nicely. So how do I put that up? I simply go to the right folder in PhotoBucket. And I only had 30 something frames. It's at 8 by 8 inches by 150 pixels per inch. So let's see how big that is. Come on. By right clicking and asking get info. How did I move it to the trash? So get info, and it's 24 megabytes. That's pretty big, but that should load. If it gets over 50, it's going to have trouble loading, and we'll have to reduce the resolution a little bit. So this is by far the biggest file we're going to load into PhotoBucket. So it's good if you can try to get it uploaded before the beginning of next class, because next class will work on the refined storyboard, where we choose 9 frames from our animation to tell the story in a finished storyboard. And for that, you need your stage PSD. So I'm gonna close that, I close my assets and save them. And there is a way out of your stage PSD, maybe I'll show you next class, you can save it as a full